welcome you to another Good News broadcast. I pray that you're excited tonight, looking for something that the Lord is going to do. I'm expecting something, aren't you? We have Brother Joe with us tonight. Also, we have Brother Tim, Brother Bob, Brother Glenn, and Brother Jack with us tonight, and they'll be singing for us tonight. Sister Judy is on the telephone, so be sure and call in your prayer request. We had a few names that was left over from the last program, and I don't think we got to read those out, but Myrtle Abernathy was enjoying the program, and she wanted Dallas to sing her a song. A prayer, Louise and Dolores from Indian Land needed prayer. Also, Larry and Tracy Summerow needs prayer. A prayer for Jerry. Barbara O'Daniel, prayer for physical needs. Prayer for pastor's voice and pray for her children. That's Barbara's children. Bonnie Bailey was 102 years old, and she had COVID and pneumonia. So I pray that God has moved on her and touched her, and we've been praying, and even though we didn't get to call it out, we still lift her up in prayer. Faye needs prayer for healing. Prayer for Dottie, age diabetes. Prayer for a family who lost an uncle. And we had a new one to come in today, just recently. And Peggy needs prayer. Peggy Webb, she needs prayer. She's in pain. And we're going to let Brother Tim and them bring you a song, and then we're going to go to the Lord in prayer and pray for our dear sister and those that are hurting tonight in their bodies. Go ahead, brethren.
Memories of my childhood days, I recall them now and then, gathered there with all the family dear. But the circle has been broken, it's not the same anymore. But up there we'll meet again on heaven's shore. I wonder if the family circle will be together once again over there on heaven's shining.
I want to go to the Lord in prayer, and you know, pain is not a comfortable thing to deal with, and sometimes people are in excruciating pain, and it's hard to enjoy the Lord and enjoy life when you're hurting real bad. And I know there's several of you out there that probably have pain in your bodies, but I'm to tell you that I know one who is able to release that pain tonight. So we're going to go to God in prayer, and if you will, lay your hand on the area where your pain is. If you can reach that area, I want you to lay your hand upon it, and I'm going to pray. I'm going to ask God and trust God for your healing tonight, that He will deliver that pain for you. Almighty God, our Father in heaven, I come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus. Father, we know that Jesus was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we were healed, and we are healed. And Father, I know that we have the power and authority through that name, the name of Jesus, a name above every name. And Lord, you've given us the right and the authority to use that name, and through that name we rebuke pain, we rebuke sickness, we rebuke the devil. And Father, we rebuke this pain tonight that's in this body. Touch Peggy tonight, Lord. Touch her body, Lord. I rebuke that pain in Jesus' name, and I declare the divine healing from the precious blood stains that was shed upon Calvary's brow. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. He was bruised for our transgressions, and by His stripes we are healed, and we claim it, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Go ahead, brethren, and bring us another song.
Long ago, I didn't have anything. My life had no meaning till I heard about Calvary. Then I knelt down and prayed. Jesus saved me that day. Now Jesus is living in me. He's in my feet when I'm walking. He's in my tongue when I'm talking. He's in my eyes, and now I can see. He's in the song that I'm singing. In my heart, His joy is ringing. Jesus is living in me. Top of the mountain, over lost terrible sea. I'm living in His glory, and I love to tell the story how Jesus is living in me. He's in my feet when I'm walking, in my tongue when I'm talking, in my eyes now I can see. He's in the song that I'm singing. In my heart, His joy is ringing. Jesus is living in me. Yes, Jesus is living in me.
We want to send up prayers for Rick and Linda Clark and Nikki. Linda's having tests. Pray for Ronnie Clark, who has cancer. Also for Brenda Mitchell, has cancer. And a song in prayer for this. Also, Doc Teague from Lincolnton had a birthday on January the 30th, and we wish her a happy birthday. And also, we want to send out a birthday wish and song for Elaine Klontz. also Gene Kurtze and Ivanel Hicks. And Danny Overcash says he appreciates the program and the prayers. And I have this little birthday song, and I'm going to send this out to all those that had a birthday. I'm not no great singer, but this is the way it goes. A happy birthday to you, a happy birthday to you. May you feel Jesus near every day of the year. A happy birthday to you, a happy birthday to you. May it be the best years of your life. Happy birthday. Go ahead, gentlemen, bring us a song.
As I travel through this pilgrim, and there is a friend who walks with me, leads me safely to the cities, and it is the Christ.
We'd like for you to continue praying for Billy Henderson for the healing of his eyes. He wanted to hear the song A Rose Without a Thorn, and I think that's Brother Dallas sings that song. So when Brother Dallas is back, we'll have him to sing that for you, Billy. Karen from down in Concord is sick, needs prayer, asked us to remember the friends and loved ones in Ukraine. And we want to send a song out to Karen. And Karen, we rebuke that sickness in Jesus' name. Pray for Darrell Fielding. He fell and broke his leg, so we know that he's been in some pain, and God is with us, and he will help us. Prayer for Johnny for back and other health issues. Alton Clark, Herschel Reed, Frankie Reed, and sing If You Don't Love Your Neighbor. Pray for Bill and Mary Bryant, Wesley Bryant, and also remember Reverend Russell Cook and his wife in prayer. So we're going to let these gentlemen bless you in a song. Go ahead, gentlemen. Elsie Cantrell needs prayer and a song, and she wants to hear the song, I Believe. A special prayer for Frank Termeyer and his wife Carol and their daughters Cherie Cannon and Debbie McDaniel. Also pray for a pastor at New Outlook in Taylorsville, prayer for Jody, and special prayer for Michael Riley. He's having major surgery, so please remember these wonderful folks in prayer. Also, would like for you to pray for Nancy. She needs prayer for her health and her eyes. And we want to remember Noah Keenard and his wife, Lou Ann. Noah is going to be taking his last treatment of radiation on February the 15th, and praise the Lord, we're trusting, believing that everything's going to be good. I took 44 treatments of radiation, and as far as I know, I'm cancer-free, I'm good, and I thank God and praise God for it. Pray for Jewel Hartis and her daughter Carol, and thanks for everyone who prays for thank everyone who prays for each one. Want to thank everyone who prays for the good news, and we need prayer. And so thank you for your prayers. And pray for Ronald and Peggy from Gastonia. Pray for Nettie Jewel Dunn, and pray for Jean Sawyers. She passed away on June the 12th, and we want to send a song out in remembrance of her, and also pray for Louise Moses, Ruby Simmons, and a sister-in-law, Georgia Gillis, and Linda Willard, Pat Kelsey, and Michelle Baer. Also pray for the healing of the body for Darnell and Joanne. They need prayer for the healing of their bodies. So go ahead, gentlemen, and bless these folks in a song. Praise the Lord.
When I see the sunrise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children play, God's amazing grace, and I believe there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place called Calvary. I believe in a man whose name is Jesus, and I believe that he gave his life for me. I was there the day my mama went to heaven.
Praise the Lord. God is so good to us. I was sitting here meditating and thinking about the situation that surrounds us with how the world is and even our own homeland. Thinking about, I wonder how displeased God is with America. When our country was established, it was said that in God we trust. We're supposed to be a God-fearing nation. But it seems as though nobody really cares anymore. Whatever you want to do, it goes. It's all right. And God's not pleased with it. And I know that the Word of God teaches us that in the last days, perilous times shall come. Men shall be lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. And it's sad that even church folks seem to love the pleasures of the world more than they love God. And that may be offensive to some of you, but God is looking for soldiers. He's looking for people who is really dedicated. And we wonder sometimes why things are happening as they are. But if you remember all the way back into the book of Deuteronomy, when God brought the children of Israel out of Egypt's bondage, He made a covenant with them. He says, if you keep my statutes and my commandments, I will not put any of these plagues upon you that I put upon the Egyptians. But see, man failed. And that's why sometimes these plagues and things have fallen upon us. My friend, God wants us to live holy. It's a holy way. It's not just any old way will do, but it's a holy way. And it cost us something. Something that people don't realize how precious it was. When Jesus Christ had to spill His blood upon an old rugged cross, and it ran down to the ground for you and for me, that we might have salvation, that we could be saved. And once He saved us, He wanted us to live godly in Christ Jesus. But we're going to let them go ahead and bring you another song at this time. Go ahead, gentlemen.
The one called in. There are many people who take their Christians and they live like Christians on the Sabbath day. But from
Yeah.
you don't love your neighbor, then you don't love God. If you love God, then you'll love your neighbor. Amen. These are the ones who've given on the broadcast this week. And let me say again, thank you for all that you have sacrificed and given that we may be on the air. We have Moline from Hiddenite, North Carolina. Dickie and Mildred from Lenore. We have Ann from Mount Holly. Darnell and Joanne from Rock Hill, South Carolina. It's good to hear from our folks down in South Carolina. And it's good to hear from some dear folks that we hadn't heard from before. And they have been watching the program for quite a while. But thank God they're giving on the broadcast. And it is so much appreciated. You're such a blessing. You'll never know. We have a listener from Charlotte. Jewel from Menhill. Another Jewel from Mountain City, Tennessee. Jane from Morganton, Patty from Morganton, Annie from Salisbury, Ronald and Peggy from Gastonia, Bill and Lib from West Jefferson, Linda and Lee from Morganton, Grady and Judy from over in Hickory, here in Hickory, and a listener in Hickory, Carol from Menhill, Violet from Rockingham, Gertie from Stanley, North Carolina, Billy Ray from up in North Wilkesboro, North Carolina, and Dorothy from Norwood, and also Nancy from down in Wadesboro. And we just want to say to you that if you live close around Wilkes County and you would like to come to our church, you're welcome to come. We're located at 800 Kelly Street. If you're coming down from Boone on 421, you'll get off on 1618 going toward Lenore and Taylorsville. And when you come to the first traffic light, you will take a right, go to the stop sign and take another right, and go to the dead end. And the Wilkesboro Church of God is right there on the left on the little hill. And we would be more than glad to have you to come out and be with us. Brother Joe's a wonderful teacher. He'll teach us the Word of God, and we just have a good time in the Lord. I'd like for you to remember Robert Tollison and his family, especially his caregiver Regina. And he wants to hear the song, The Sandals That Jesus Wore. Prayer and a song for Lois Mooningham and Sister Joyce Britton. Also prayer for Janice Jones, for her neighbor, having surgery, Deborah, her neighbor. Prayer for Sandra Brown and her mother, Joan. Prayer and a song for family of Gloria Harrison. Also Larry Chandler, Ed Blake, and Clear Creek Nursing Home. Bless your heart. Special request for a miracle for a listener. We believe in miracles. Signs and wonders and miracles shall follow them that believe. And I'm a believer. I am a believer. I don't care what anybody else says or thinks or does. I am a believer. I strongly believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I strongly believe that there's a God in heaven who spoke everything into existence. Man had nothing to do with it. God spoke it into existence. And God so loved this world that He gave His only begotten Son, that we might have life and have it more abundantly. And I'm not going to preach right now, but praise the Lord. I believe in miracles. I'm a believer. Prayer for Nancy Chapman, who had knee surgery. Grandma's back. Remember her. Prayer for Dorothy Linebarger. And the whole world wants the whole world to be saved. What a wonderful thought to have on your mind. How many people today really are concerned about the lost? We have so many lost people. We have so many hypocrites and backsliders and, you shouldn't have said that word. We don't believe in that. Well, if you're not for Him, then you're against Him. And if you're for Him, you'll live for Him, and you'll live right, and you'll live righteous, and you'll live holy, and you'll let go of the things of this world, and you'll cling on to Him and hold on to Him. Go ahead, gentlemen, and bring us another song.
Here the labor is so hard, and the workers are so tired, and our weary hearts are longing for a rest. And we find we're getting anxious to be in that happy home where we'll receive
a few more days to get our love on again.
We may look into the skies and tears will fill our eyes, and our burdened hearts grow heavier every day. First we cry, oh Lord, please come and take our children home, and then we look around us and we say,
wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There are so many wandering out in sin. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our love on
the family scattered here and there, but Lord, we love them dear, and maybe we can help them find a way. Then waiting is the cause, and that they mightn't be lost. Lord, that's the only reason that we say,
wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There are so many wandering out in sin. Just a little longer, please, Jesus. A few more days to get our wounds in. A few more days to get our wounds in.
If you have your Bibles and you're able to get to one, or you have one in your home and you're watching the broadcast, I would like for you to just read along with me, and we're going to talk about some things here that is very, very important. And we need to realize what an impact we have on other people, people who live around us, people who know us. And it's important that we understand what God requires of us. Now, in the Gospel of Matthew, in chapter 10, Jesus had called his 12 disciples, and he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Now, I have a question. Said Jesus called them, the 12. Before he called them unto him to talk to them, to teach them, did he not choose them on the way? So after he had chosen them and called them, now he is ministering to them, and this is what he gave to them to start their ministry. Are we sure that we have been called by God to become ministers and evangelists, teachers and pastors? Or did Grandma call us? Or did Grandpa call us? Or did we just decide to go into ministry because, oh, it's an easy life, and we get a parsonage to live in, a new car to drive every year, and we get a big salary, and all we got to do is just stand up there and read a few words and make a few comments and dismiss and go home? We need to take seriously what God is saying to us. You better make sure that it's God calling you and not man, not grandma, not grandpa, not mama or daddy. I know God called me. No man called me, God called me. And he called me one Sunday morning. He called me up from a piano to a rostrum, and there I stood weeping and crying and praying in the darkness. It was like I was in the midst of total darkness. I didn't know really how to pray or how to be saved, but I began to pray and began to weep and cry, and God saw my heart. God called me that day. When I felt that heaviness go off of me and something went from around me, I felt something come around me.
And when God called me to Jesus and I accepted Jesus as my Savior, He clothed me in a robe of righteousness and crowned me with His glory. Because I never had a desire to read God's Word. I never had a desire to know anything about Christianity. But after that day, on that Sunday morning at the 11 o'clock hour, I couldn't wait to start reading the Word of God to find out about this man called Jesus. He's such a wonderful man. He called me. He gave me power against unclean spirits to cast them out. He equipped me and He sent me to heal all manners of sickness and all manners of disease. And of course, as we read here, He gives us the names of the 12 disciples. And these 12 Jesus sent forth and He commanded them. And this is what He said. Men, if we're called of God and God has called us and God has equipped us, here's our commission. First of all, He told the disciples, go not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not. But first, go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But today, God is saying to us in America, pastors, evangelists, teachers, disciples, apostles, whatever, go to the lost sheep of the house of America. There's lost sheep in America. And as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Oh, yes, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Then He commissioned them. Heal the sick. Cleanse the leper. Raise the dead. Cast out devils. Freely ye have received, freely give. I don't believe in that. I ain't gonna touch that. I might get a demon in me if I lay my hands on somebody. You better do what God called you to do, what God anointed you to do. No wonder there's so much rebellion and evil and wickedness in this world. The devil's on the loose. The devil's on a rampage. People running around here full of demonic spirits, and nobody has sense enough to realize what the problem is. They want to send them to a psychiatrist. They want to put them on mental illness medicine. That's not what they need. They need the pure old devil cast out of them is what they need. And they need to give their heart to Jesus and accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, and they'll be in their right mind. Hey, provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purses, nor scrip for your journey. Neither two coats, neither shoes, nor yet stays, for the workman is worthy of his meat. And in whatsoever city or town ye shall enter, inquire in it is worthy, and there abide till ye go thence. And when you come into a house, salute it. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it be not worthy, let your peace return to you. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your words, when ye depart out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet. For verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. I hope somebody understands tonight what I'm talking about, what I'm saying. I hope somebody will look back and realize, are you doing what you're supposed to be doing? Have you got lazy? Have you went sleeping on the job? Behold, I send you forth as sheep in amongst the wolves. Be therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. But listen, but be aware of men, for they will deliver you up to councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogue, and ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and who? The Gentiles, who were us. But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given you in that same hour what ye shall speak. That's me. I never know what I'm going to say until I get ready to get up. You know why? I used to prepare sermons. I used to do outlines. And I used to do all that. But I found out it's better to wait upon the Lord and let the Holy Spirit lead you and guide you in what He would say or what He would have you to say. But when they shall come giving you in that same hour what ye shall speak. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. Well, praise God, I'm glad for the day of Pentecost. I'm glad that day come when Jesus, after He was crucified and rose from the dead, He ascended back to the Father, sat down at the right hand, and prayed to the Father, and the Father sent us that another Comforter, which was the Holy Ghost. And when the Spirit of truth had been sent, when the Holy Spirit comes, it will lead you and guide you into all truths. It's not what we get in theology. It's what we get in neology. It's what we get down on our knees when the Holy Spirit begins to speak to us. And when we pick up this precious word and begin to read it, the Holy Spirit will begin to reveal the meaning of what is written in this book. But the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you, and the brother shall deliver you up, the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. We have to endure. Never, ever have you heard of crime, murdering, killing the wife and children and killing themselves and killing one another. We're in the last days. But when they persecute you in this city, flee ye into another. For verily I say unto ye, ye shall not have gone over the city of Israel till the Son of Man be come. The disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his Lord. It is enough for the disciple that he be as his master, and the servant as his Lord. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more shall they call them of his household? How many times have you heard remarks made? Well, that's of the devil. We don't believe in that. That's of the devil. You better watch what you're saying. We don't work through the power of Beelzebub. We work through the power of the Holy Spirit that God sent down on the day of Pentecost and baptized the 120 that was in the upper room. And that fire has been spreading and spreading and spreading. And we need another outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We need another spreading of that Holy Ghost fire. A cup on our pastors, our teachers, our leaders, our guides. Refresh us, O Lord. Refresh us. Revive us. Revive us. Oh, hallelujah. I feel something when I say revive us. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We need revival. We need to be revived. We've been in the ice box too long. It's time to get on fire for God. It's time to do the things that Jesus has called us to do. Fear them not, therefore, for there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed and hid that shall not be known. What I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in light, and what ye hear in the ear, that preach ye upon the housetops. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. And that is none other than God himself. How many people today really fear God? Are not two spare a soul for a far thing, and one of them shall not fall on the ground without your Father? But even the very hairs of your head are numbered. Fear ye not, therefore, ye are of more value than many sparrows. And listen to this. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Come on now. Come on. Are we supposed to be witnesses? Are we supposed to be testimonies? Are we supposed to tell our friends and loved ones and people that we meet that we are saved, that we are a child of God, that we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior? Shouldn't we lift up Jesus? Oh, don't mention that around me. I don't want to hear that. Well, are you ashamed? If you're ashamed and you don't tell others about Jesus, then you're denying him before men. And what did he say? What did Jesus say? Him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. For I am come to set a man at variance against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and a man's foes shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Let me tell you something. People love this world and the things of this world. When it comes revival time, when it comes church time, when it's time to get up and go to Sunday school to be taught the Word of God and to learn of the Word of God and to learn about heaven and learn about what it takes to get to heaven and to learn about what Jesus requires of us and expects out of us to be righteous and holy and that our bodies are not our own. We're bought with a price. We belong to God, and our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Now, which temple are you? Are you a holy vessel or an unholy vessel? Maybe you need to get sanctified. Maybe you need to get born again or get born again. Because he that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Are we willing to take up the cross and follow Jesus? Are you pastors worthy to suffer persecution and all manner of evil speaking against you, lies told upon you? Are you willing to bear that? We have to. And he that taketh not his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it, and he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. He that receiveth you receiveth me, and he that receiveth me receiveth him that sent me. And he that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward, and he that receiveth a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whosoever shall give to drink unto one of these little ones a cup of cold water, only in the name of a disciple, verily I say unto you, he shall in no wise lose his reward. What are we doing for the Lord? What are we doing for him? I know our time is running out. But remember what it said in the book of Titus, chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. We're talking about Jesus, our Savior. It's not by works of righteousness which we have done, but it's according to His mercy He saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost, which He shed on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior. Do you really know Jesus tonight as your Savior? Do you really know Him? Do you realize the love and the compassion that He had for you to die for you? 1 John 4:14 says, "And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world." We don't get there on our own. We have to go through Jesus Christ. That's the only way we can get there. Mary said, "My spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior," when she greeted Elizabeth. John 4:42 says, "For we have heard Him ourselves and know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world." Do you know Him? Can you say that for the true heart? "For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost." Are you lost tonight? Have you gone so far back that you don't feel His Spirit or His presence anymore? Well, He came to seek you and to save you. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You want to live forever through eternity? I do. Don't you? We're going to let these gentlemen take us off with a song. And while they're singing, the prayer line is open. If you want to give your heart to Jesus, there's someone here to pray with you. Would you call? Go ahead, gentlemen.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. And then things change, you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God of the mountain is the God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times is the God in the bad times. And the God of the day is the God in the night. You talk of faith when you're up on the mountain. Oh, the talk comes easy when life's
much to thank.